Today we will be comparing two of the Ludlum microR meters. First we have the model 19, which is housed in an aluminum housing, a little bit heavier, and it has a sodium iodide crystal. This one we'll see from background to 5000 microR or 5 mR. It has a battery readout by pushing the button. It has a high voltage readout by pushing a button and seeing on the bottom scale. It is equipped with click audio. It's also equipped with a fast and slow response time and a push button backlight to illuminate the display. So as you can see, in fast position, we can hold the reset button to bring it to zero and the slow position. Next microR meter that we'll be comparing is the model 3019. When we turn it on, it will show us the battery voltage on startup, and then it will take an 8-second sigma count for background. Anytime that the readings increase 2 sigma over background, this light will flash and you will get an indication, audio indication, like so. This one's a little lighter weight. It's made out of a polycarbonate housing. It has 2 units of measurement that are user selectable. It can also have click audio. This one does not right now. It has 3 modes of operation. The first one is the rate meter mode that will go back and forth depending on increases. Then we have the max rate mode that will lock into the highest reading that it has seen since it's been on. And we have a count mode that has a user selectable time that will basically just take a scalar count, and both units are visible at the end of the count. As you can see, this display is a little easier to read and definitely a lot lighter weight. The crystal, I have not yet seen one break, and I've done several drop tests on them, which we will be doing today. We will drop both of these instruments from 1 meter onto a concrete surface. We will do it 3 times on each axis, starting with the model 19. Test the second axis, dropping it with the handle end down, battery compartment down. And finally the third axis. Prior to the drops, I took a source reading. Should go about full scale. See our needle's a little bent after dropping it. And our readings up here to read about 100 microR different. About 20% lower than before. Our backlight still works. Audio still works. We have some dents in the can that weren't there prior to the drop test. Second axis. Well, we'll just continue on. We'll put them back when we're done. We'll put these back in and see if it works, huh? Battery door was still on. No batteries. We have some scuffs. It doesn't look like we have any cracks.
at about 330 before. Maybe a little bit of an increase. Overall, pretty good.
This is the sodium iodide crystal from the model 19 from our earlier drop test. After removing it, we found it to be cracked and the cause for our lower readings.